How much longer is this gonna take?
Your daughter's on the line. Just running the encryption.
Black hell!
What's up, Grim?
The data you glommed off the rig. There's no way the Georgians could have gotten this much intel without a man inside the CIA.
Fisher, you're up.
Dad?
Sarah. Hi.
Where are you?
On my way home.
I thought you were gonna call last week.
Something came up. I'm sorry.
That's all right. Were you in Georgia?
Honey, you know I can't answer that.
Yeah, I know. I was just watching it on TV. Oh!
Sarah. Sarah! Anybody have a line back to Third Echelon?
I'm here, Fisher.
What the hell's going on?
Nicolas just declared war on the U.S.
What?
The Georgians hit our communications, transportation, power grids. We still don't know how extensive the damage is.
What's our defense? What are we doing?
What do we have? Nicolas caught us with our pants down. All we've got is the laptop you pulled off the oil rig.
My daughter.
I know. I've got people heading over there. This whole country's a mess.
I need to see Sarah.
You know what you need to do. We're helpless until we find Nicolas. You're heading for the CIA. Your mission just became critical.
Failure at the Red Bear Army Community Hospital in Mississippi resulted in 17 deaths and over 30 injuries. Both county electricity and backup generators were destroyed, leaving military train traveling to Norfolk, Virginia, collided with a commuter rail line after an apparent failure of its automated routing system. U.S. military has not released the contents of the train's cargo, though federal authorities have evacuated a 20-mile radius surrounding the wreckage. Though no official death toll has been given, initial reports indicate the deaths of over 40 enlisted men. Potential civilian casualties are believed to be much lower.
Newspapers talking about cyber terrorism, an information crisis, information warfare. Call it what you will, but realize that no American is safe until we mobilize our army.
Rescue workers, their information grid entirely disabled, were unable to respond to the crash for nearly an hour. Injuries became fatalities as to combat Nicolas, the Georgian president still in hiding. Though his first wave of cyber terrorism focused on military targets, intelligence proposes that a large-scale civilian target could just as easily...
We have faced terror before and triumphed. I promise here to the American people that we will triumph again. Earth is too small a place for the perpetrators of these acts to hide. The United States and her allies will enact a justice that is swift, cruel, and absolute.
CIA Headquarters, Langley, Virginia, USA, October 31st, 2004, 22:19 hours. Track down the mole in the CIA. Hours after the attack on the oil rig, Georgian President Nicolas launched a devastating wave of remote technology-based terrorist attacks as retaliation against the US. The only lead to Nicolas's whereabouts is a mole thought to be operating out of the Central Intelligence Agency.
Time to get to work, Fisher. Let me reiterate. We cannot afford any casualties. The NSA doesn't operate in the U.S. We don't spy on other agencies.
I'm not here.
That's right. You've lost existence privileges until the mission's over. You've synced a timer on your offset to a pause in the ventilation system fans. You'll have a limited window of opportunity to use it for insertion.
Nice. They don't show you a timer? Oh, yes, they do. So, greetings, fellow Earthlings. So, welcome back with some more... Splinter Cell, Tom Clancy's Splinter Cell to be exact. I still keep saying arena. Anyway, so we want to get up here and those guys won't see us, so you don't need to worry about that. We need to get up here and let me just quick save again. So, sort of a big tragedy happened with me. We want to slide this door open. The thing about this level is it's confusing. And the van just started. and we're in. So the thing about this level is it's pretty confusing and there's a ton of things which you can do but don't know how to. And yeah, we just want to drop down here and we want to climb up this thing. Because we gentlemen, we don't pick locks unless necessary. So we just want to head in here, and I'm just going to go into this corner first, where it's super dark and nice, and then I shall quick save, and then move along. For I don't remember exactly how well this entire level works. And we can basically just take a rest here. Let's hope we can, anyway. We've got a shielded camera there which we cannot shoot and destroy. Just the way I prefer cameras to be. So I will just save the game here. And we shall hope that the camera doesn't look in our general direction when we head out to do what we want to. And there's darkness here which played in our favor, the camera almost caught me. And I'm just going to quick save again here. Because thing is,
we have an intruder. Yep.
It's the sound of my footsteps that kept me away. Nothing else, nothing else at all. Yep, he did not see me. As should all wise men be. And we can just get down here, no issues, no biggie. And just head into the shadows and let me just quick save again because I don't want to go through that. So yeah, this game is sort of archaic. There's a guy who just went in. You don't really need to bother about him as much. Except he just, you know, like goes over through the other side. And let me just take these off so that you guys can actually appreciate the graphics here. And we can get a data stick from this computer. And we've got some extra supplies here which we might just need later on in the game. Because, well, it is quite... no, I do not want to open the game door. What I want to do is I want to peek through it underneath. Now, you guys might not be able to see much here, but there are like literally two guys. You can see one guy right there beyond the steel scanner thing, the doorway, whatever you call it. And there's another guy right there who is looking right at us, and there's another guy in this room who keeps patrolling and looking at us. So we want to... yeah, right there. So we don't want to utilize this exit here. What we want to do instead is take the roundabout way. And I shall be saving the game here because I do not want to redo all of that. And we have a camera here which we want to be wary of because, well, it's a camera. Whew, that was not as intended. Not at all, sir. The funny thing about this game is that modern graphics cards don't support the lighting schemes in this game anymore. And the older graphics card, well, they aren't any good either. As in, you don't get the older graphics cards anymore. And yeah, so all we are literally left to do here is use emulation softwares like this, which aren't perfect, but well, I guess they at least get the job done. So yeah. So let's just chill out here for a moment after we've opened the door, because I suppose there's a guy somewhere around there and we do not want to upset him, now, do we? Let's just check up the patrol routes of this guy. He was looking straight at us, by the way. So yeah, we just want to move along to this side as slowly as possible and just climb up here. And I'm just going to quick save the game again. No, Now, why we needed to do all those acrobatics was that we wanted to go there, right over there. And yeah, it's sadly the only way you can do that. Just keep following that guy. You can climb onto the table, onto these seats or whatever they are to stay better hidden, and hope that those people can, these good guys who are actually the bad guys in that case, can't see us. And we're just gonna wait for that guy. Good. He turned over, and let's see what we can do here right now. I did save the game once. And hopefully nobody can see us right now. Okay, the guy's guy from over there is coming here. We don't even have, oh, we do! I was about to say, we don't have any heat vision in this game either. How are we gonna find out who's looking at us and who's not? But as it turns out, we do have heat vision. Yeah, let me just stay right here. I'm just gonna create another save file. Though obviously I don't want to do all of that again. Wait, did I? Yeah, so I'm guess there because it seemed like a good spot for a save. And I'll just quick save here. We don't need to be that slow. We can go faster. Come here. Alright then. Let's get moving. And just like that. So yeah, that was a well-executed way of doing things. And I'm surprised that I managed to pull all that off, because the first time around it was a nightmare for me, practically. So anyway...
Are you going to be staying at the hospital? You mean when she wakes up? Listen, thanks for coming in. I know the last thing you want to be doing at a time like this is answering questions.
You want to stay away from that side?
It's a coincidence. Thanks for your understanding. Let me know if there's anything we can do.
Let's see what we can do here. I think this guy is going to go into the elevator and we need to... Actually, that was alright. Damn. Plus there's also that guy over there, which makes things just that much more difficult. Now what can I do? I don't even have my gun! Oh wait, I do. But that's gonna make a lot of noise. Let's try this. Let's quickly try this. Wait, what? A4 ring rounds, fine. Why can't I equip this? I can't equip this for some reason. Okay. Alright, I'm just gonna save here, I guess. I thought I could, you know, just shoot the floor or something and create a distraction, but apparently not. I have to distract this guy somehow. Oh wait, I've got an object right here. I can throw this away yonder. But here's the problem, this guy is looking straight at us.
Bizarre.
Ah, that guy saw us. Beautiful. Nope.
Intruder!
And the patrol parts in this game are so... just... I just realized something. We're gonna need that again. And I literally just threw it away. Okay, well the iron is hot. Let's strike. Fine. Oh wait, we're gonna go down. Well, that was I guess the dumb AI in this game plays in our favor sometimes, because the guy up there should have seen us, but he didn't. And I'm just gonna create another save here, in celebration of that. Let's just come out and we want to stick to the shadows here. Actually, I don't think we do. I don't think we do. What we do want to do is, yeah, that autosave. Yep.
Just got word from our man inside. He says your F-2000's in place. You can retrieve it in the storage room behind the generator backup.
Goody.
I'd be ignorant not to arm you, but keep it holstered. One agency fatality means the mission's over.
Yeah, you know what? Yeah, we can do that again. As long as we don't overwrite and save too. And yeah, that's just because there's literally nobody here, we can just literally keep running through this potion without any repercussions. And just take things a little slow here. I'm just going to quick save. And yeah.
Good. It's not ideal, but it looks like we're covered.
Like I said, this you're not supposed to be here.
And that's why I quick saved. So if you go in there, you'll find some extras.
Good. It's not ideal, but it looks like we're covered.
Like I said, this is tight as security gets unless Congress admits we can't run this place on pocket change.
You said it wasn't critical.
It's not. I think we can maintain.
You're sure?
Yeah, I'm sure. I'm just tired.
Overtime?
I'm on hour 15.
It's a crisis, man. Crunch time.
Meaning I gotta get back to it.
I'll see you around.
And that was that. So basically, the means of room code is 2019, when back when everything was nice and there was no COVID-19 pandemic. So yeah, I guess I'll remember that. And since I'm a lazy bastard who doesn't want to do all of that again, I'm just going to load up another save here. Before I make any risky move, I always save, simply because of the virtue of the move being risky. Let's see here, does this guy... So we want to be wary of that guard right there, you know, the one in the coat, the tuxedo.
Good. It's not ideal, but it looks like we're covered.
Like I said, this is tight as security gets unless Congress admits we can't run this place on pocket change.
You said it wasn't critical.
It's not. I think we can maintain.
You're sure?
Yeah.
Oh my god! You said it wasn't critical.
It's not. I think we can maintain.
You're sure?
Yeah, I'm sure.
That's right, this
area.
I'm
just tired.
Overtime?
I'm on hour 15.
It's a crisis, man. Crunch time.
Meaning I gotta get back to it.
I'll see you around.
Yeah, so basically what we want to do here... Let me just quickly save the game here. And basically what we want to... I think that was a really bad move. What we want to do is just stick to the wall so that this guy can't see us. The road from the other side just takes us to this part. To this side, anyway. And we just want to stick to the shadows here. Hopefully this guy won't be able to see us. Yes, because he's sticking over to the other side of the room. And there's the technician. What we want is right here inside this area.
Supposed to be here
again, didn't I? Let me see here. Yeah, it works. That works wonderfully for me. We want to go there, actually. That's basically our objective.
Who did that?
Nice. Now, all we wanted to do was just grab him and knock him out. Yeah, that's much better. And I'll just save the game here, I'll knock this guy out. What the fuck just happened? What did just happen? So I guess I need to wait for him to go back inside before I decide to knock this guy out. Because otherwise he's going to make a sound. See, these are the tiny little details which I like. Since Sam Fisher isn't holding a gun anymore. were noted in from datastick. Datastick recovered from satchel. Let us go ahead and read that now. We've got two datasticks. From David to Jonathan. Respond and destroy. Mr. Sutton, where the hell did you manage to find those picks? That's the cleanest piece of intel I've seen in this corner of the world since forever. Regardless, a search for blasting Madison's corpses isn't going anywhere fast. So they knew that Blaustein and Madison were dead. Why did they not tell the NSA about that? Were they just trying to play it close to the chest? Were they involved in this entire crisis? I guess we shall find out on this level. They're trying to work with Georgian police, but it's like working with vampires at a blood drive. Sergeant Lotkipanidze can lie faster than we can ask questions. I don't think we're ever going to see those bodies. David T. Dunham. Or something else I've under. This is the layout of the entire place. And yeah, under the data stick. Daniel Kanemoto. Alfonso Stevenson. Tech services. Keypad installation. Fonts. So this is basically the code that we needed. I'll get the keypad installed on the technical services room door before the end of day today. I'll be right outside your window. Let me know if I'm bugging you. The default code will be 7687, but you should change it on 8-hour shifts until they cut down the level of alert. If we get any days off this week, right, we should do something. God knows I'm going to need a drink after all this. Dan. Good guy, Dan. Okay, so just let the guy come back here. And we can actually just see if they step out right now. And what we want to do here is wait until, you know, he's... Okay, I'm just going to take a little bit of distance. I don't want to have that guy notice me. How many drinks does this guy have? Huh. Interesting. Anyway. So what was the code again? 7687. I get the fact that it's immersive that you have to manually enter the codes here. And let's just enter here. And we want to keep that light off. Let's just enter this place here. I think there's something back there that we have to do because as far as I remember correctly, there was something back there. Anyway, I'll just save the game here. Once. Save one. Yes, I do want to overwrite that save. Thank you very much. And see, right now is not our opportunity. This guy, he does not notice us. This would be an opportune moment to go over to this side, to this end at least. And I don't exactly recall what we were supposed to do here. Or maybe I just wandered off here for nothing. I don't remember exactly. I feel like there was something that we were supposed to do here, but yeah. Nope, nothing at all. So I guess that's that. We just want to, you know, make sure that guy comes over on this side before we make a move. And now we are free to go here. I'm just going to take this medical kit and I'm going to move here quickly as possible. And I'm going to use this computer once. One note added from datastick. Battery backup power room code is 110598. Alright, I'll just save here. 10598. Oh, wait, I could have done without this. This part. I'll be honest with you, this sucks. This part okay. Really does suck. 0J-8675307-0. I have a question. How can I get up these containers here? Can I even do that? I really hope I can. Because otherwise going through this maze will be a bit of a struggle, and it's one struggle which I'm not willing to partake in, if you know what I'm saying. I'm not supposed to be here. Why do you think I am here? Because I'm not supposed to be here. Oh yeah, finally got up there. And I guess I might as well just save the game here since I did finally get up here. Yes, please, I want to override the save. And let's just take this opportunity to go into the mission information, read this data stick. From Hilco Block to Chris Weldon. Coffee break. Looks like we're gonna be in for a long one again tonight. If you want to hit the cafeteria for a coffee later, I'll be in the battery room next door. Let yourself in. I might not be able to hear you for the hum. The door code this shift is 110598. An invitation for coffee. How curious. I'm just gonna take it slow here. No, I did not mean to do that. I am terribly sorry. Did I save it and save one? Yes, I did. Excuse me? Oh, thank you. And yeah, I guess I'll just need to let this guy go and just do his thing. Because I am in the dark. And look at Sam Fisher floating in the air, just look at him. My, this is a talented guy, isn't he? Doing this, I feel like I'm exploiting a bug, but then again, that's just how this game might be in general, because, well, it's this game we're talking about here. Yeah, let's just try and find a window where we can exploit.
You're not supposed to be here!
Okay. Point taken. I guess. And let's just quickly run over into the shadows here, or at least this part. And let me just save the game again, because if I'm not wrong, something bad happens here as well. But yeah, overall, compared to the other levels of the game, this level still is quite enjoyable. And I think this is where our SC20K lies. Yeah, right here. Look at this beauty. Just look at this beauty. A 556 SC20K. I'll just click save here. And yeah, I don't really know where I'm supposed to go apart from this.
Yeah, I guess. Do you know anybody who was hurt?
My mouse wheel isn't working properly. I dislike that.
Fisher, GPS shows you within sight of the server. Grimsdottir's standing by. She'll be ready to trace the leak as soon as you can get us access.
So yeah, compared to the rest of the levels of this game, this level is actually quite somber, if you will. And we just want to remain here, because there's also another general over there who's on the prowl. And we don't exactly want to disturb him for the time being. Yeah, just let this guy go on that patrol route over there. You know, like when he goes towards the right. Then we can start our maneuver. Let this thing open. And yes, here we are. Now, here's the tricky part of this mission. Let me just create another save file here. I like to keep saving. A lot of people don't like that. I mean, nobody's complained to me yet. But anyway. Do I know the keypad for this place? I wonder. Mission information. Backup battery power room code is... I don't actually. I think it was save one. Yes, it was. Alright, so now we can enter either of these chambers through it. So you basically have to go there and then, you know, go back down the right path to get to the side where you want to go. And yeah. Let us try this here. Those guys won't come down, so you don't need to worry about it. But if we want to tap into the surveillance, we need to go get over there. Otherwise, things get a little difficult. Where is this guy, I wonder? Can't see any traces of a living human being here. Whoopsie daisies. It's a miracle he didn't notice us. And as you can see, there's literally a guy right here. And let's hope he doesn't notice us either. Because if he did, it would be really bad. There's somebody up there as well. So, yeah, we just want to be a little careful. And instead of, I guess, doing things here, we could just drop down from there, because that's pretty much our exit route. And exit through this side, I suppose. Because right now, we're gonna get made.
You're not supposed to.
So I guess the only way to do this thing is... I guess y'all are getting sticky shop, then, I suppose. Actually, you know what? I could just... Yeah. Let me just go ahead and do that. I'll just stick to this shadow. This corner right here. Like before. And I'll wait for that guy to come out, because there's literally no other way apart from knocking them out to get an objective. We have to knock at least that guy out, and he will stumble onto
Hello,
his body.
What the hell?
Hey, I did not... Come on! Oh, this game can be a little frustrating from time to time.
What the hell?
Yeah, you can see what the hell all you want after you're done here. And I'm just going to go ahead and hide your body in the shadows. If I walk at normal paces, I can't catch him. If I walk at fast paces, I end up alerting him. And that, ladies and gentlemen, is Splinter Cell in a nutshell. I guess I was meant to use the SC-30K here, and didn't, but oh well, whatever works for you then.
What the hell?
Oh my god! Another problem with this game is that you literally have to grab people from behind. And if you're not exactly behind them, you know, when you try and grab them, practically everybody's gonna know. They're just gonna get alerted. You're gonna end up touching them and they're gonna get alerted. This is in stark contrast to how things run in Splinter Cell Chaos Theory, where you can actually just literally mash the forward button when you're in front of somebody and it still won't matter. Because Sam won't go forward.
All right, Lambert. We're in.
Good. Grim?
I'm inside. Just there. The leak is a low-security PC registered to one Mitchell Doherty.
Great. Doherty's PC is your new objective, Fisher. I'll upload the details to your opsat.
Doherty's PC. Yes, I can. Yes, I can. Why did I not do that before? Because I'm an idiot, that's why. And I'm just going to... Do I want to save here? I shall. Let us risk it.
Come out here where I can see you!
Oh my god. I made too much noise. And we shall be saving the game here again, shall we? Let's just wait for the goon little guy to come over. And yeah, we can save the game here. Whew. This game isn't the most refined of all the Splinter Cell games, but Well, it's still better than a... I don't know, I mean, mechanics-wise, I find it to be better than Pandora Tomorrow. Not exactly mechanics-wise, Pandora Tomorrow's mechanics were much better than this. I find it to be better than Pandora Tomorrow in terms of... I don't know how I find it better than Pandora Tomorrow, actually. I don't think I do. I do not think I do. Anyway, let me just save it here. And let us just stick to this corner here. And let this guy pass. Yeah.
Please note, there is no longer a smoking section in the cafeteria. All smoking is restricted to designated smoking terraces on the fifth floor.
Does this door open? No, it does not. They all require key cards anyway. Alright, so I've got my sticky shocker equipped, and here is where the issues begin. We've got a guy in here. Huh. And we basically want to use this window to get in. Because if you go along this way, the alarms will sound, and yeah, you know what's going to happen after that. Oh, wait. Curious. Let me try taking this path here. But no, this path is highly illuminated, and I'm guessing this will be as well.
Who is that?
Well, that worked out. Do not close on me. Good job. And yeah, I don't know why this is happening, probably because of my third-party lighting software, but just get on the stool here and save the game, and let just things just die down. He'll be back before soon. It was just a distraction sort of a thing. It's not too bad, nothing to be wary about. What is problematic here is the fact that we've got two spinning cameras that provide 360 degree surveillance. I think I've got some mono stabbed Georgian's computer to trace the intelligence leak to the Georgians. Fine, that's quite specific. I mean, why do you want to trace the intelligence leak to the Georgians? Couldn't it have been somebody else, the Chinese, for example? Is there somebody up there? Yep. So it looks to be. We're just going to let this guy go because, well, he isn't really any of our concern. And, yeah, we just want to make sure that these cameras are not looking for us, and I shall now attempt to make a break for it. Wow. Okay, so this guy's coming back here. And we want to avoid his gaze if we can. So this guy basically surveys the entire area, is it? Provides surveillance, sorry. Pardon my language. Why can you see me? I don't understand that. You should not be able to see me. Well, this worked, I guess. Let's see how far we can go before the cameras can catch us. I don't want to get too close, for the guy will be watching out at any moment now. Okay, let's just... hope that nobody will catch us here.
Terminal access will be restricted to users and administrators until further notice.
Tight. That was tight. Damn, that was tight. I can't believe I pulled that off. Nice. Anyway, so in celebration I shall now save the game. Since I did such an amazing, amazing job. And apparently we've got a camera here. And there seems to be no other way but to knock this light out. I hope no one got alerted to that. If they did, well, I need a keypad here. I need a key code here. Oh my god, I was supposed to knock out that guard guy. Do I have an access code of something? Or of some sort? Oh yes, I do. It's 110700. I wonder why I'm so... So basically this was another safe spot right here. The one which I didn't notice back then. So I wonder where I got that safe, that code from. Anyway, the code was again, what was it again? 110700. Anyway. Yeah, good job, look away.
Well, tell Clarence I'm gonna have his ass and his badge for this. Because I'm looking at agency photographs of Red Bear on TV. Find out what agency media the press has. Anything they haven't shown yet, get back before they do. I don't know. I don't care. Fix it.
Huh. That's an angry young man. As some would like to see. Let's hope that we won't get caught doing this. And yeah, well, I'll just prefer to stick these shadows here for the time being. Hoping he can't see me. And he did not see me. That's quite amazing, actually. Yeah, I did not mean to do that, but okay, fine. Oh my god. Huh, so I guess we're safe for the time being. And so this is basically a little bit of information about this gun which we'll be facing now on throughout our missions here. We don't need to go back, so no need to worry about that guy there. So basically let me just save here again. Since I feel like I might need it, since I feel like something might go bad here. So anyway, this gun, it senses heat. And if you throw anything hot in front of it, let me just go ahead and chuck this flare out there. It will shoot at it. Until the heat no longer exists. Now, I guess nothing bad happened with that, so I'm just going to interact with this turret. And you've got two options. You can disable the infrared field detection, or you could deactivate the turret. Anything works, to be honest. And yeah, it looks like Sam's just using his fingers. You basically want to check this option if you want the turret to attack enemy combatants. You could not do that either. So right now it has got IFF disabled, and I could deactivate it, but I like to leave things the way they were because I'm a ghost, you know. Except for that one little bit of a flare shell, if you will, left there on the floor there. But yeah, you get the point. Nothing to be taken here. And I think we want to be going higher this time. Yes? No? Yes. So let me just see, quick save in this brightly lit elevator here.
I just sent you Doherty's file. He's an information retriever, office 508.
What do I do with Doherty?
Stay out of his way for now. We'll get back to you when we find more on him.
we can't go here, of course. What we want to go is this media room right here. And let me just check whether there's something over there. Seems nice and dark.
Found traces of the media in a secure data forwarding service in Holland. Another in Bangkok, three in Canada.
Any order?
Nope.
Take it back. Turn up the volume.
The foolish, avarice, and arrogance of a nation that still believes there is such a thing as a world superpower.
Take it back to Belize? What, the chainsaw?
Of a nation that still believes there is...
No, it's like a moaning in the background.
That still believes there...
You hear that?
That still believes...
I don't hear it.
That still believes...
It's right there. A cow, maybe.
Still believes...
I honestly don't hear it. I think there's a chain wrapping around the chapel.
Let me check this with the media people.
All right, I'll be here.
And that's basically Doherty right there. We want to access his computer. And then we will have to follow him. There's no rush though, because he's a pretty nice guy. He's gonna just go out and go for a smoke break.
Who is that?
Where did you come from? Let's see where you go. Okay, I'm surprised he did not notice me there. But,
Great work, Fisher. How are we doing, Grim?
Working on it. Very clever back door. Looks like Philip Mass's work. Bouncing to a server. Surf Kalina underscore VA, which is the Kalina Tech building in... Oh, black hell, somebody spotted me. They shut down.
We'll call back. Fisher, we're gonna need you to bag Doherty.
What happened with Grimsdottir?
We'll worry about that. You worry about Doherty. Wait for him to take a smoke break. It'll make grabbing him easier. Details on your upset.
So yeah, just stick to this wall. That guy will notice us. And we have some generous shadows right here. And we just want to go into the cinema theater and watch a nice movie right here. Make sure you drop down to these seats.
Three points of attack. Two transformers coming from County Electric Supply and the backup generator. Agent Marks has been trying to sell us on the idea of electrostatic fuel bombs, but the blast radius doesn't figure. A logic bomb activated in the hospital's archival system 70 hours earlier, approximately 10 p.m. on the 28th of October, effectively wiped out our chances of tracing the attack digitally. However, we do know how they gained access to the transformers. These are hospital security access codes. The only parties who have these codes are hospital directors and us. If these codes came from CIA
That's one boring meeting, to be honest.
Yeah? Yeah, I'm telling them about it now. Hold on a sec. I'm going to be a few minutes if you guys want to take a break. All right, I'm back.
Oh, man, that's rough, Don.
Yeah. Like on the train. Is she all right?
She's fine, but it was close. I mean, she says she
What was
saw
that?
Bodies. Hey, careful with your coffee.
So, now my whole family's spooked. My wife doesn't want to send the kids to school tomorrow.
You spilled your coffee.
Christ. In fact, I'm supposed to call her. I gotta run.
All right, I'm going for a smoke. You gonna be...
Come on.
No, I'm taking off.
Hey, you spilled coffee. Somebody's gonna have to clean that up.
I gotta run, Mitch. Take it easy.
So a quick saving is the best advice I can give you here. You can see how well designed the patrol bots are in this game. Yeah, you just want to make sure that you get in as he is getting in as well. Otherwise, you're gonna have a bit of a problem here. Just a bit, not too much. I mean, you'll just get locked and you'll have to restart from the previous save. How many tissues will this guy dispose of? Is my question. And yeah, I'm just gonna go ahead and grab him right here.
Junior Wilkes is in position for extraction. He's with Special Agent Baxter.
What is that?
Interrogations expert. They've got a disappearance truck parked in the back.
Drop that man!
He's on his rounds right now. Let him pass.
Junior Wilkes is in position for extraction. He's with Special Agent Baxter, an interrogations expert. They've got a disappearance truck parked in the back.
A disappearance truck, they call it. Yeah, so now I think we are free to leave. I'm not sure. Let me see here. Not yet. Unfortunately, not yet. Let me just quick save the game here. And yeah, alright, fine, let's go. I hope this shall suffice. If it does not, then my deepest apologies. Come on then. Don't be shy. Yeah, just like that. Just ignore the elephant in the room. Or rather Sam Fisher. Because, you know, he won't really be serving you any purpose. It's actually quite thrilling doing things this way, to be honest. Let me just take him here and wait for that guy to complete his routine again. You don't see me, do you? Fool, young fool. This place actually looks quite beautiful, to be honest. Come, we shall go again. And hopefully we shall be able to make it in time. Because there are two lights here, which we need to avoid. And honestly, carrying this guy, and there are a few ways to do this. You can literally like carry this guy all the way, or you could like grab him and move him like I am. But here's the thing. In either case, it's gonna be pretty difficult for you, and it's mostly a thing of timing
itself. I've got another complication for you. Some CIA security dick is chatting up Junior Wilkes and Baxter.
How were they spotted?
They weren't hiding. NSA presence on Langley is completely legit.
The only problem is me and Doherty.
Right. A SIGINT ninja with an unconscious bureaucrat on his shoulder is less than copacetic, so don't let him see you.
Okay, so this is as far as we go, because right now we need to knock this guy out just so that we can open the store. That's it. And yeah, there is a third way. It's not a very good way, but it's a way. So the third way involves... Let me just override the save here. Save too. Whoops. So yeah, there is a third way, and the way is actually quite complex. What you want to do is, actually it makes things simpler, but it takes a little while longer, or maybe it takes even shorter, who knows. But here's what you want to do. You want to make sure that everybody... Let me just quick save right here. Let's be a little quick. On the uptake at least. Let us see if this works. And it did not. Did not work. I can afford to be a little quicker, to be honest. This guy's supposed to chat with somebody here. Since he hasn't yet, I'm going to assume he isn't going to do just that. So I will try to.
Who is that? Show yourself.
Who was it again? Or was it the sound of me walking quickly that triggered it? So yeah, the third way is you go ahead and you shoot everybody that you can. And yeah. Basically you eliminate everybody. You don't kill them, you use your airfall rounds and your sticky shockers to do the job for you. But essentially you're doing just that. Eliminating all your targets. So there's a guy down there and I don't know how far we can go. Yes sir, you do. That was nothing. You're just being paranoid. Come. Let us take our mind of these things. Of these petty things. And yeah, you can... Do I want a quick save right now? Okay. I guess we have to go with the old strategy then. Knock him out while he's there. And you're in as good a position as any, to be honest. This mission and the next one are, well, clunky to say the least. I don't want to call them clunky, but clunky they are. Just look at this not so beautiful scenery. Is it morning already? Look at the sky. Wow. Anyway, let's hope we don't, you know. Are we literally walking on the rails right now? Yes, we are, sir. Yes, we are. And now I wonder where that other guy is. There should be a guy patrolling downstairs. Is he upstairs? Ah, yes. I think he's on the way back upstairs. I'm just going to quick save here. I really wanted to like a no knockout run through, but I guess it's not really possible in this game. As far as the eye can see, anyway. Let's hope he didn't notice us. If he did, then too bad. Fine, let's just keep moving. Hopefully he won't see us. I'm just gonna quick save here again because, well, I've got the opportunity to do so. Alright, so... You know what? Come here. You're eliminated. Alright, come on. Come on. Just had to do it. I guess there's no other way around it then. Alright then. Quick save, and we're getting near the end of the level. Sorry for such a long gameplay, guys, but yeah, there doesn't really seem to be any other way to go about this than what we are doing right here. I'm pretty sure there are other folk who know how to do this, but I, being I, don't. So let's see if we can probably... I like how he just shrugs the body off his shoulders like it's a cape. Like, get the fuck down, bitch. Yeah. Let's see here. We can probably stash the body right here. Yep, we can. Thank God for nitrogen goggles.
You mean you actually deal with humans sometimes?
Rarely, but...
Awesome. So, what do you use?
I don't understand the question.
You know, what kind of drugs do you use?
I'm clean.
I think he means for interrogations, for getting people to
you
talk.
You doing all right?
No, nice and easy. We're gonna go to sleep. So yeah, I completely forgot we do have to knock out this guy anyway, so... Might as well just begin now. Good job, son. A very good job. Nice. Huh.
Thank God, I thought he would never go away.
This our friend?
That's the man.
Pleased to meet you.
And that must be Doherty.
He's all yours.
Did Lambert tell you about Sarah?
No.
She's fine. The blackout spooked her, but she's completely all right. Don't get too emotional. Let's get out of here.
Thanks, Wilkes.
Fuck, that was a long time. CIA headquarters, Langley, Virginia, USA, November 1st, 2004, 0059 hours. Took about 2.5 hours. Interrogation of Mitchell Doherty reveals a compulsive disorder that moved him to hold data to an insecure computer, thereby allowing an intelligence leak. Grimsdottir traces the leak to the nearby offices of Galena Tech. During the process, her intrusion is detected, necessitating an emergency infiltration of Galena Tech. Damn, that was one level. I mean, I did not expect things to go that way. They did go quite smooth, smoother than before, but at one level, it also went quite, you know, unsatisfactorily. I mean, I should have probably taken the path of, you know, like, eliminating all the guards first, using sticky shockers and whatnot, and then moving on to carrying this guy's body out. And talking about this guy, poor guy, though, I mean, he literally had to get interrogated by CIA spooks to cover up the fact that he was holding data. I mean, not only does he lose his job now, but he also got, like, a few nails and teeth pulled out and something. So, probably got electrocuted nice few times, squashed over the fire or something. I don't know what the CIA guys do. But anyway, yeah, so the story thus far, we found the amount of data that could have been, you know, that could have been accumulated could only originate from the CIA headquarters. Those are in Langley, Virginia, and basically we found out when we tapped into the servers, we basically found out that it was this guy, Doherty, who had been hoarding all that data on an insecure computer, and that is pretty much what got Nicolaides his power to make an information attack on the USA. So right now, Grimsdottir, while we were accessing the servers, we found out that it was basically a computer in Galena Tech that we got the access from. So, but she got, you know, like, as you can read here, she got detected and they had to evacuate Galena Tech. And that is where we're going next. Anyway, so until next time, see you guys later. Farewell, fellow earthlings.